Hey guys, welcome back. It's time for my January random favorites. As I mentioned in my beauty video, I had to separate these because if not, it was going to be like the longest video ever. So I decided to separate the videos in two. All right guys, so to start with my random favorites, I'm going to show you this so I can get it out of the way. It is a scale. So obviously, you know, New Year's resolutions, losing weight, getting into shape, all of that stuff. And my scale kind of like, it was kind of messed up. So I knew I had to get a new one. And what better than to get this like super cute, purpley, glittery one. I don't know if you can see the glitter that I actually found at the Target Bullseye section. You can see my ring light there. It's crazy. I found it at the Bullseye section, and it's, let me tell you, it's a motivation. I like stepping on it in the morning. I feel like, I don't know, it's like glam. So I've been really, really liking this a lot, and it's been part of like my motivation to continue like my whole, you know, like getting healthier thingamajig, which I've actually lost 7 pounds. I'm super excited about that. So that's another favorite. Tying into that, guys, I have really been loving, again, my Fitness Pal, because my favorite way to like actually like lose weight is to count calories. For me, it's like the easiest way. It's just my best way to do it. So I can still have things that I like to have. I don't feel guilty about it. I don't, you know what I mean? Because I can just put it in there and then I'll kind of know where I stand during the day and how many calories or whatever it is that I have left. And that's pretty much it. And then it works for me. It works. It has worked in the past and I like it. I like being able to kind of see what I'm putting in my body and stuff like that. So for me, it's a big help. I really, really love that app. And the other app that I've been liking is DietBet. So one of my really, really good friends, she does DietBet every so often, and it has worked for her, and it has worked for numerous people. I don't know if you guys follow the account Fat Girl Fed Up. That's kind of how I started getting into that, and then my friend also told me about it. So what DietBet is that you kind of bet with other people, like you do a pool and you bet like $30, for example, and the pool could go up to like $1 million, let's say, and there's like 20,000 people playing, and they give you like, for example, mine that I'm doing right now is that by February 3rd, I have to have lost a certain percentage of weight, which is only 8 pounds, and I've already lost 7. So I'm obviously gonna make it, and then I will probably get some of the pot, you know what I mean? And at least you'll probably get at least your $30 back. So it's not bad. It kind of motivates you. It kind of keeps you accountable. And I actually really, really like it. And that's how Fat Girl Fed Up, which is, what's her name? Oh my God, what is her name? I can't remember her name right now. But that's how she started. She actually started weighing 485 pounds and now she weighs like 170 or 60 or something like that. And she started with DietBet, and that has actually helped her. And now she does like her own like groups and pools to like help other people get on it. So I really liked it, and I've been really loving that app too. All right, these Victoria's Secret slippers. Aren't these the cutest little thing? First of all, look at the pink cart they have right here. Second of all, these pom-poms. Like, this is the cutest thing ever. Time I saw these, they had them in red. They had them in this gray. They had them in black. They had what other color did they have them? I think it was pink. I didn't know what I was going to do with myself because I didn't know what color I was going to get. But I absolutely love. I got gray because I thought it was like neutral and it would like match everything. And I love them. And they're super duper comfortable. Speaking of Victoria's Secret, they're PJs, okay? I can't show you it right now because it's watching. I can't show you it right now because it's washing, but I will insert a picture so you know which ones they are. It's like the top and bottom, long sleeve pants. So comfortable. I feel like I'm like in a cloud. I feel like when I sleep, I feel like I'm sleeping on a cloud just because of the pajamas, because I don't even feel them. Like it's like you don't feel that you have them on. They feel so nice and just I don't know how to explain it, but I totally recommend those pajamas. I suggest you get them. They can be expensive sometimes, but if you wait for the sales and you use like their coupons and stuff, that's the time to get them, guys. Favorite has been actually journaling. Guys, I haven't journaled in so long. And this year I was kind of like, sometimes you forget. Like even though I've done a memory jars before, a lot of times I forget, and then it's like a huge jar, like accumulating space. But I thought that this year I would journal, and I always have notebooks around because I'm the type of person that I love jotting things down. I have to jot things down. I'm not the type of person to use the notes thing on my phone. That doesn't work for me. It's like if I didn't jot anything down, and then I forget half the stuff, and it's like it's madness. So I always have notebooks like these, always like with me. Or like this one, for example. Like this is where I have like jotted down like my favorites, my to-do lists, like I have that with me like on a daily basis. And also use like smaller ones. I've used all different sizes. And yeah, I'm a total notebook person. Like I will never be upset if you give me a notebook and a pen. So yeah, I've been loving journaling. I decided to start with this one. It just says "Love what you do." I picked it up a really long time ago in the bullseye section, the dollar spot, and it says this journal belongs to you. Write your name, and then I've been journaling a little bit, and I have actually really enjoyed it because aside from the fact that you can write special things on the days, you can also vent. So I kind of love
My
that too.
next
Favorite has actually been reading again. Guys, I love reading so much, but I haven't like really sat down and read the way I should in a really, really long time. I love reading, and when I was little, I used to carry around like baskets of books and baskets of books everywhere, and it was like my thing was reading. If you got me with a book, I was fine wherever we were going, to a doctor's appointment, to visit, to wherever where I had to be quiet, I was good with a book. That was my thing. I didn't need to have toys. I didn't need to have any of that. I needed a book and I was good. My mom would go grocery shopping and I'd sit in the cart and she would just fill me with books and I would be happy. And books are awesome. I love books. Like, whoever doesn't like reading, you have no idea what you're missing out on. So the latest book that I've read has been this one. It's Inventing Joy. And she is the one that invented the huggable hangers, the, what was that mop called? The miracle mop. What else? I can't remember. I can't remember right now. But yeah, she's the woman that invented the huggable hangers, among other things. And I read the entire book already. I absolutely love it. She gives you a lot of advice aside from talking about her life. Like, she kind of gives you advice and what you should do and how you shouldn't give up and everything that she went through, etc., etc. It's a really, really, really good book, and I really enjoyed it. It was not expensive. I got it off of HSN, and I love it. So now I'm on to a different book, and I feel so like fulfilled that like I read this book and I'm enjoying it, and I'm just back in my reading game. I'm loving it. So to accompany that book that I got, this was so crazy. This is so crazy how like things become your favorites. She was including a pair of reader glasses with her book. And for those of you that don't know, I use contact lenses. I do need glasses or contact lenses. And what I always use is my contact lenses. I do have a pair of glasses. So when I saw that she was including readers, of course I got them with no prescription. And I didn't think that I was gonna use these or anything like that, but I got them. And I was like, let me try these on. And I'm like so in love with these glasses. Like, you have no idea. Like, I'll literally randomly, like, I don't know if you guys saw a post I put on Instagram. I'll literally like randomly wear them throughout the day. And I have my contacts on and they don't bother me, obviously, because they have no prescription. But they are like the glasses that I've been looking for forever. Because, sometimes you want to use your glasses if you want to rest your eyes from contacts or whatever it is. And I have never found glasses that have like literally like filled me. If you know what I mean, that I have been happy with the way that they look on me. So these came in. Like, I'm in love with the frame. I'm in love with everything. They're like that turquoise turquoise or whatever, and they have like these purple legs, and I think they look so amazing. I absolutely love them. Like, I think they look super cute on me. I love them so much. And everybody has told me that they really, really like them. You guys let me know. I also inserted a picture on Instagram. So I really want to get some done with my prescription, but that are just like these. So that way I can use them if I ever want to rest my eyes. Because these, if I want to use them, I have to have my contacts in, obviously, because there's no prescription. And I think I'm going to keep them on because I love them that much. All right, guys. So my next random favorite has to be this gift that my Secret Santa gave me. Like, she is just amazing. This Betsy Johnson wallet that she got for me. It's amazing. Amazing. It has like the two compartments. It has this one here where you can keep like your cards and your driver's license. And then it has this other compartment right here where you can keep like receipts, money, whatever it is that you want to keep. And if you just want to take it like this with you, you can just do that. And I absolutely love it. You can even fit your phone in here. You know what I mean? So like if you want to take this, you can fit your phone and everything in here. I love this so much. It's like, it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. And I love it so, 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 so much. And then on top of that, she also got me this Betsy Johnson purse. Those of you know that I love Betsy Johnson. Like I mentioned in my other video, I really want to do like a Betsy Johnson collection. I have several things from her and I love her. I love her stuff. I love everything. All right. So this is the purse. It's beautiful black with the huge pink bow. Super roomy inside. Super roomy inside. Like, it's so awesome. Another thing that she got me that I absolutely am loving and I'm so obsessed with is this Betsy Johnson lunch tote. Look how gorgeous this is. Like, the pattern is just so beautiful. It has this little thing right here, and you can either carry it here or you can also carry it here. And who does not want a lunch tote like this? So you can go to work in style with all your like healthy snacks inside. And who wouldn't want this? Like, it's awesome. I love it. I'm obsessed with it. And that is another one of my random favorites. My gosh, guys, it's getting so hot. Those of you that don't know what the YouTube struggle is, it's a struggle sometimes. It's so hot with this ring light. It's crazy. All right, guys. So the next thing that I've been loving, I didn't bring it with me. I totally forgot to bring it upstairs. But I've been loving doing crossword puzzles again. And I love crossword puzzles. Like, I'm a beast in crossword puzzles. Every time I go to a baby shower, I will win the crossword puzzle game. Like, I will win it, guys. And I know that I'll win it because I don't know what it is. I'm just so good at crossword puzzles and I love doing them. And I have been doing them again. Like, they gave my son one for Christmas in school. And the one that's doing it is me. Like, I want to get them some crossword puzzles too. So, like, they like it too, but they don't like it as much as I do. But I want to kind of, like, get them into it as much as I am because that is so good for your brain. And it's entertaining and it's, and you know, it's, the good thing is that it's entertaining and it's good for your brain. And I really love doing them. Like, I have been just in that book, like, all month long doing crossword puzzles. And I absolutely love it. Like, I carry it with me everywhere. And I love doing them. I'm watching Christmas movies, even though we're in January already, but I love them so much that I have like a list of Christmas movies that I need to watch, like in this notebook here. And I will like check them off when I watch them. I love, like, if I don't have the chance to watch it in Christmas, like, I need to continue and finish watching them. So that's a thing. Loving this series that I found on Netflix, like, on a whim somewhere, and it's called Broadchurch, and it's like super interesting. I kind of want to watch it again because I watch it on and off here and there while I'm doing makeup or things like that, and I miss things. But it's really interesting. It's about a kid that like shows up dead one day, and that's kind of how it starts. And it's like the whole mystery unfolding of what happened that day, who saw him, who was there, who killed him, because it's like, supposedly it's a town that there's like no violence, like a bunch of stuff. So It's like super interesting to see like how everything starts unfolding. Six, I don't even know if it has more than one season, but it's been really interesting. I'll insert like a picture of it here so you kind of can see. And I have been really liking that. And I like those like kind of like mystery, like suspenseful kind of series like that. So I've been really liking that one. I've been loving Valentine's Day, guys. And if you guys follow me on other places, you guys have kind of realized that Valentine's Day is my favorite holiday. Like, literally, I'm obsessed with Valentine's Day. Like, I thought Christmas was my favorite holiday. No, it's Valentine's Day. All right, guys, like, it literally is. I love Valentine's Day. At work, I made up this game that we've been playing since 3 years back. And it's just like Secret Santa, but it's Secret Cupid, and it's kind of the same thing. But we do like a theme with it, like from a movie, and then everybody plays a character, and like we just go off with the Secret Cupid, and we all dress the same, like on the last day where we're gonna reveal who our person is, and give our final gift. We all dress the same, we all go to dinner, we have like an amazing time, and I love it because it's all of us co-workers getting along, you know, it's awesome like to work with amazing people and that you spend all these hours in a day with is amazing. So yeah, guys, Valentine's Day has been a thing, and following along with that, our Secret Cupid game at work. And then my last favorite is a song, and I just want to like show it to you guys. I don't know if I'm gonna get copyrighted or whatever it is. And it's from Maluma, and it's the song Corazón. And I just love it. My coworker is the one that actually brought me to it, and I am obsessed, okay? I am obsessed. All right, hold on, it's gonna start. It has Portuguese in it, which is why I love it too. All right, guys, so that's been like my favorite song this month. I really, really like it. Super catchy, super cool. And yeah, guys, that's it for my random favorites, guys. It's time to let you guys go. And I will see you next time. Don't forget to subscribe, to hit the notification bell, to like, to comment, to support. I love you guys, and I will see you next time. Bye, my loves.